Okay, so here's where dynamic parallelism steps in. It solves both of these problems really neatly. What I've got here is an example of how QuickSort would sort a series of numbers. At the top level, a single kernel partitions the numbers into two groups, then launches two QuickSort kernels, one on each group, and so on down. It would already have all the information it needs to decide whether to launch and how many threads to use because it's just done the partitioning, so it doesn't have to communicate this back to the CPU. That's the first problem taken care of. It solves the second problem because as these kernels run, they each launch as soon as they finish partitioning. That means my sort progresses asynchronously. For example, this one on the left will launch its children while the one on the right is still working because there's more work to do on the right-hand side here. Each sort will be running independently of any others. I'm not waiting around for the slowest sort anymore, and my GPU is kept busy. So here's what the code looks like. I'm not going to get into detail about the partitioning function because we're looking at dynamic launchers here, and you already covered the partitioning in a previous lecture. The important things to notice is there's no host-side management of data or launchers needed. Everything happens inside the code itself. Here are my launchers inside my kernel of my next QuickSort kernels. So my code's nice and simple, and the kernel launches its two children into separate streams. Remember that CUDA streams run simultaneously, which means my two subsorts will execute in parallel. Without these streams, everything would run sequentially because both of these launchers would end up in the null stream. And that would defeat the purpose of the parallel sort to have my program running sequentially. So let's have a quick look back at the sort diagram to show you what I mean. If each launch runs sequentially, then I would do the left side first, then its children, left side first here, then the right-hand side, then I would come back and do the right-hand side next, and then so on. And so what we would see is that each step gets run sequentially instead of in parallel, which defeats the purpose of the parallel sort. So by launching the sort into different streams, we run both the left and right sorts in parallel. So I would run both of these together, and then each of their children, and so on, and I'd get the parallel performance I'm looking for. I've combined dynamic parallelism with CUDA streams to get the parallel execution that I just would not be able to do any other way.